888-971-SAGE, 888-971-7243. LeBron James, NBA superstar, and Kevin Durant, also an NBA superstar, trash Donald Trump. Laura Ingraham trashed them, trashing Trump. And guess who got called racist? More common sense gun control proposals, this time from many of the students who attend that high school. Will that matter? Even Bernie Sanders now says Obama should have done more about the Russian interference. You know why he didn't? Because he assumed that the Russians were trying to help Trump. He knew, Barack Obama did, that Trump had absolutely no chance whatsoever of winning. So what difference does it make? To coin a phrase. Tucker Carlson had a fantastic interview with Rob Reiner. I'll tell you about the interview I had with him some years ago. And he accused Reiner of coming out against McCarthyism while engaging in McCarthyism. But first, the family that took in Nicholas Cruz this morning on Good Morning America said they had no idea that they were harboring a mass murderer.
Guys, for joining us.
Thank you. And
James and Kimberly, I can't begin to imagine what it's like for your family. So how are you guys holding up?
It's a roller coaster of emotions. It's still tough. We're still hurting. We're still grieving.
Feeling for the families that's affected.
And you opened your home to Cruz for nearly 3 months.
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm.
And you tried to get him counseling. And what was he like in your home?
Nothing like they portray on television or in the media.
Everything everybody seems to know, we didn't know. We had rules, and he followed every rule to the T.
And before he moved into your home, how well did you know him?
I had met him a couple times before. He had spent the night at the house, and he was very polite. He seemed normal.
And Kimberly, can you take us back to that day? Was there anything unusual, out of the normal, with his behavior before that day?
No. The only thing that was maybe different was that he didn't go to school. He usually drives him to school with him in the morning. He didn't go sometimes happens.
He said he didn't go to school on Valentine's Day.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
That's what he told him.
But when did you realize what he had done?
After the SWAT team called me and asked if I knew where my son Nicholas was. And I said, he's not my son, but I don't know where he's at. And at that point, I got in touch with my son, who was fleeing the scene at that point. And a description came out, and we put two and two together, me and my son, and we figured out what was happening.
And what was going through your mind when this happened? Did you both find out at the same time?
No, she was home sleeping. And at that point, I was panic-stricken for her safety, so I called the SWAT officer back to get the police back to my home to check on her.
And after all this happened, at one point, you did get a chance to see Nicholas. And what did you say to him? Did he speak back to you? Did he say anything back?
It was at the police station when they were going past us, and I went after him. I really wanted to strangle him more than anything. And everything I wanted to say, I tried to reserve myself. I said, really, Nick? Really? Yelled at him. And he mumbled something, but I didn't hear it. And he said he was sorry.
He said he was sorry.
But I didn't hear that. I was just furious and heartbroken. Absolutely just heartbroken, devastated. I still can't process it, what he's done, because this wasn't the person that we knew. Mm-hmm. Not at all.
And he was friends with your son.
Yes, sir.
Right.
How's your son holding up?
He's angry. Yeah. He's angry. He's betrayed. He's upset.
Furious.
He was at that school, too, and he had friends at that school.
And he was at school that day, James, and I know Nicholas texted your son.
Yes, sir.
What were those texts like?
He told my son he was going to the movies. And he said he had something to tell him. And my son pressed him, what is it? He goes, nothing bad, bro. And he goes, and that was it. And then he said he was going to the movies. And then the last text my son got was, yo. And that was it. And that was about 2:18, I believe.
Do you have any idea why you think he texted your son?
No idea. No idea.
And Mr. Lewis, thank you for joining us as well. And what is the latest with the FBI investigation of this all?
Well, we're continuing to cooperate with them. These folks opened their house up to the FBI. They've opened their phones. They've cooperated in every way. And I just want people to know out there, these are good people who are trying to do the right thing. They took this young man and got him into another school. They got him a job. They brought him into their home and tried to show him love. The young man, even Nick, indicated that he was very happy in this home. And now, you know, like they say, no good deed goes unpunished.
But are you worried about any legal repercussions with the family?
These folks aren't worried. They're here to tell what happened. If they get sued, if somebody tries to find fault with them. Mm-hmm. You know, this young man, who they're most concerned about, their own son, mm-hmm. he's part of this community, too. These are his friends. He wants to go back to the school. They want to get back to their lives. But they want people to know, because this Nick was at their house, they want to tell people everything that they know, including the FBI and all law enforcement. And again, they've cooperated from day one.
And there have been so many reports about Nicholas's alleged social media use and about guns and posting of guns, about killing small animals. Did you know anything about any of that?
No, sir. We knew he had one Instagram account that my son had, and I guess that would be the normal one. These other Instagram accounts that he had, we had no idea about. My son had no idea about. As far as the animal killings, he never did anything like that at our house. We have animals, and he loved our animals. Our animals loved him.
And you were aware that he had weapons when he moved into your home?
Absolutely.
And where were they kept?
Before he moved in, one of the stipulations is he had to get a gun safe. And we got a gun safe on the way back from Lantana from moving his stuff to our house.
And didn't have free access to this gun safe?
No, no. I thought I had the only key to the gun safe.
And had he ever asked you beforehand to use a gun to take it out of the safe?
He asked twice. Once I said yes because he wanted to clean it. Mm-hmm. And I don't know which gun he wanted to clean, but he said he wanted to clean a gun. I said okay. And another time he asked and I told him no. It wasn't a good time.
And why did you tell him no?
I don't know what the situation was in the house. It wasn't a good time. I don't know, we were getting ready to leave or getting ready to sit down for dinner or something, but it wasn't a good time.
And judging from any past interaction with him, it seemed like you had no problem with him having a weapon.
No, not at all. He followed the rules.
They weren't allowed to be out if we weren't home or one of us wasn't home. And he knew that, and to our knowledge, he never had them out. And as far as the animals goes, I am very much an animal person. Anybody who knows me knows that. There's no way I'd let anybody in my house if I thought he was torturing animals at all. And if we'd known anything about the Instagram accounts, or I don't even know how to use Instagram, a little old school, but if we had known anything about that, he wouldn't have even been in our home. That wouldn't even been an option.
And do you have a message for the families out there who've lost children or have lost loved ones in this tragedy?
Nothing I can say will heal them. We hurt for them deeply.
Very much so. We're devastated, and I can't imagine the pain they must be feeling. And like he said, nothing that we can say is going to be any kind of help, but we're very sorry that, you know, they had this experience and never should have happened.
Yeah.
And again, if we had known any of the things that we're hearing, we're learning a lot about all of this just the same as everybody else, you know, and we feel betrayed as well and just shocked. It's crushed everybody's world in our community.
Yeah, I'm sure it's very overwhelming for you. And do you plan on seeing Nicholas?
Not at this time.
No.
All right. Thank you guys so much, Jane and Kimberly. Thank you so much for joining me.
Mr.
Lewis, thank you.
Thank you for having us very much.
Thank you, sir.
And we'll be right back.
When we come back, the FBI was contacted not once, but twice. An American counterterrorism expert who's worked as an FBI special agent was not amused. Says heads need to roll on this. And a message from the principal of the high school where Nicholas Cruz murdered 17 classmates. 888-971-SAGE, 888-971-7243. This is Larry Elder. Do not leave town.